Hello and welcome back to Quantum Leap. In this video, we'll present one of the most challenging and promising candidates for the building blocks of quantum computing, which may become the transistor of quantum computers, topological qubits. First up, what is topology? Topology is a field of geometry that examines the features of space that are conserved when subjected to continuous transformation, such as stretching, bending, and twisting, but not ripping or gluing. It focuses on the study of concepts like continuity, connectedness, compactness, and convergence, regardless of the specific geometric features of objects. Based on this perspective, a donut and a regular coffee cup are considered topologically identical because they both possess a single hole. Topological physics is the study of the microscopic geometries and symmetries that lead to particular phenomena. Topologically defined states have been one of the most elusive topics in quantum mechanics for decades. They are an interesting class of quantum states of matter that exhibit distinctive features due to their underlying topology. In other words, these states result from the interaction of quantum physics and system geometry. Unlike the states of matter in conventional physical systems, topological states are characterized by global properties that are intrinsically isolated from the local details. This means that small changes in the system do not affect the overall behavior of the physical state of interest. The properties of topological materials emerge from patterns of long-range quantum entanglement and could theoretically be employed to create a topological quantum computer. The key fundamental change in quantum computation is to robustly store quantum states for long periods of time and evolve them according to specific quantum gates. So, what kind of physical systems are accommodating this elusive phenomenon? Topological quantum states mostly emerge in low-dimensional systems, such as at the surface, intersection, or edge of particular materials. For instance, topological insulators. A topological insulator is a material whose interior behaves as an electrical insulator while its surface behaves as an electrical conductor, meaning that electrons can only move along the surface of the material. Another example is quantum Hall systems, typically realized in two-dimensional electron gases subjected to a strong magnetic field, which exhibit the fractional quantum Hall effect. Isolated sheets of atoms residing in graphene in two-dimensional optical lattices of cold atoms are also examples of effective low-dimensional physical systems. Certain superconductors possess unique properties that combine superconductivity with non-trivial topological characteristics. There are many possible models of anionic systems with certain number of distinct particle types. In 1937, Ettore Majorana theoretically introduced a particle that is its own antiparticle. This is simply the statement that creating and annihilating a particle should be done with the same quantum operator. Decades later, in 1997, Alexei Kitaev specified that Majorana fermions in two-dimensional systems will enable a completely protected storage of quantum information due to their remarkable non-abelian statistics. Qubits, which are based on the principles of topological physics, exhibit exotic quantum states known as anions, which are neither bosonic nor fermionic quasiparticles. A quasiparticle does not exist by itself. It is a phenomenon bound to the respective complex system. They are proven to exist only in two dimensions and can have quantum numbers of fractional values compared with the other elementary particles, such as electrons. An ensemble of non-abelian anions has the peculiar property that the order and orientation of particle exchanges exhibit a measurable effect, therefore making it possible to utilize this for encoding information. Encoding and manipulating quantum information with anions offers a highly desired resilience to control errors and disturbances due to their geometric robustness. The local nature of the orientations would be irrelevant. Any two paths that were topologically equivalent implemented the same quantum gate. This insight put the study of anions at the center of topological quantum computation. They are profoundly linked to quantum error correction. In a sense, anionic quantum computers implement quantum error correction at the hardware level, thus becoming resilient to control errors and perturbations. However, when it comes to supporting anions, not all topological states are equal. An underlying system must support anionic states within certain symmetry conditions. Regarding this, of particular interest are topological superconductors that support Majorana zero modes. In topological quantum computing, a qubit is composed of a group of anions, which do not appear in three-dimensional systems. In 3D, every particle is either a fermion or a boson, and exchanging two particles bring up an overall sign, either positive or negative. But in two dimensions, particles obey exchange statistics relying on complex phases. This suggests that exchange statistics of point-like particles in two spatial dimensions are richer than in three dimensions. Preparing, evolving, and measuring the outcome of anionic states are critical for performing an efficient quantum computation. The means of preparing an anionic quasiparticle state is first preparing a state-of-the-art low-dimensional microscopic system, as mentioned earlier. Then pair of particle-antiparticle may be drawn from vacuum for the purpose of initialization. Computation is supposed to perform through particle exchange called braiding. These exchanges correspond to a unitary operation on the associated physical space. In this case, it is a specific vector space called as Hilbert space. In other words, braiding is equivalent to applying a quantum gate to the qubit states. To measure the qubit states after performing a computation, anions are brought together or fused, resulting in a certain outcome. If we summarize the process of computation, first create particle-antiparticle pairs to initialize the qubits, then braid them together to perform gate operations, and finally measure the fusion outcomes. Let's stop for the basic physics of the underlying framework of topological qubits before it gets too complicated and have a look at the practical applications of the intriguing phenomenon. It is utterly fascinating since these types of particles were only discussed in the theoretical circles as a marginal and impractical field of interest so far. Microsoft Azure Quantum team has engineered devices that allow them to induce a topological phase of matter relying on a pair of Majorana zero modes, which was built on 2 decades of scientific research and recently done simulations and fabrications. Majorana zero modes emerge as bound states within topological superconductors. They manifest as zero energy states located within the excitation gap of the system. These quantum excitations must be engineered under incredibly precise conditions. The Azure Quantum team has also been able to produce what is known as a topological phase and to measure the topological gap, which qualifies the stability of the phase. By creating and maintaining a quantum phase and a measurable topological gap with Majorana zero modes, one may have a unique type of qubit. Microsoft's goal is to achieve a qubit that has built-in protection from ambient noise, necessitating fewer qubits to perform useful computations and for error corrections. These qubits should also be able to process information quickly, and one can fit more than 1 million on a wafer that is smaller than the chip on a credit card. To achieve topological immunity, a pair of Majorana zero modes that are physically separated must be used to encode quantum information. The only way to unlock the quantum information is to look at the combined states of both Majorana zero modes at the same time. Microsoft's team developed a process that merges semiconducting and superconducting materials as nanowires in an atomically precise way. Using specific magnetic fields and voltages, the devices can exhibit a topological phase with a pair of Majorana zero modes and a measurable topological gap. The team also needed to prove the reliability conferring the stability, speed, and size of the underlying physical structure of the measured topological phase. Microsoft researcher says, "We are now led by designs that are based on simulations, not just someone batting ideas around in a conference room, and now we have the unique growth and fabrication technologies to bring those ideas to life." Additionally, Microsoft's quantum leaders also say there is far more challenging work ahead on the path to creating a scalable quantum computer. Regarding Microsoft research results, it seems that there is no fundamental obstacle to producing a topological qubit. However, there is still a tremendous amount of work to do. But the fundamental part has been demonstrated. The rest is engineering path to have a robust and practical topological qubit, which is not an easy challenge as well. Thank you for watching. Please like, comment, and subscribe for more cutting-edge technological updates like this. Until next time.